everyone. In this video, I'll discuss about ionic strength, one number, two number, ionic mobility, three number, transport number or transference number, fourth number, this last one is over voltage or bubble over voltage. Okay, so see this one is, first of all, ionic strength. So first of all, have to know this ionic strength. What is ionic strength? Okay, then first definition, you know definition, this one, and this one is very very important for CSR NET GATE and GEM, IIT GEM also. Okay, ionic strength, this one. So first definition is, it is a measurement, it is a measure of the electrical intensity due to the presence of ions in the solution. Okay, this one. So this ionic strength is mainly is what? This one is, it is a measure of the electrical intensity due to the presence of ions in the solution. So in the solution, maybe this one is cation or anion. Okay, in solution this may be cation and anion. So this one is ionic strength. Ionic strength, it is denoted by this one is I, capital I, or sometimes this one is mu. Okay, so this one is ionic strength. Now it is given by the half of the sum of all the terms obtained by multiplying the molality of each ions by the square of its valency. See, this one is I equal to half of, you can write like this, m1 z1 square plus m2 z2 square plus m3 z3 square plus ... like this. Okay, this is formula where here this one is what, this m, this m1 m2 m3. So what is this, this one m1 m2 m3. So this one, right, m1 comma m2 comma m3 are molalities and this z1 z2 z3, this one is what, 1 z1 z2 z3 are the valencies of the various ions present in the solution. So this one is, are the valencies or valencies of the various ions present in solution. So this one, this first one, m1 m2 m3, this m1 m2 m3 is what, nothing but this is molalities, and z1 z2 z3 are the valencies of the various ions present in solution. Okay, this one. Suppose this is one example, say this is for a single electrode like KCl. Okay, KCl or ZnSO4, which contains only two terms, one for the cation. See here, so you can write like this, KCl, then to form K plus plus Cl. This one part is cation and another part is what, anion. Same here, zinc, ZnSO4. So after splitting this one, then Zn 2 plus plus SO4 2 minus. So this one, on the this one, this pass, this positive cation part, anion part, and here positive, then cation pair and anion pair are there. Okay, so this one. So here I equal to, you can write half m plus z plus square, m plus, this is cation part. Okay, m plus and z plus square plus m minus z minus square. Okay, this one. So this is formula. Okay, this m plus m plus, this is molality, molality of this cation, molality of cation, and this one is molality of anion, and this one is valency, valency of cation, valency of cation and valency of anion. This one understood? This one. So one is example, suppose the ionic strength of solution which is 0.1 molal in NaCl and 0.01 molal in CaCl2, calcium chloride. So assuming complete ionization may be calculated as follows. Suppose this is one is complete ionization, NaCl. Okay, this NaCl, you can write Na plus plus Cl minus, this one, or another one, this one, CaCl2 to form Ca2 plus plus Cl2Cl minus. Okay, like this. So suppose this one is Na plus and Cl minus, Ca2 plus and 2Cl minus. Here this one is molal, how much molal, this one, then you can write molality of Na plus ion, it is denoted by small m1 equal to how much, this part. Okay, 0.1, and valency of Na plus, now valency, then you can write valency of Na plus ion. So valency of Na plus ion, it is denoted by z1 equal to this valency, how much here, 1. Okay, the another one, this one is calcium chloride is there. So molality of Ca2 plus ion, it is denoted by m2 equal to the, how much this one, then this one, 0.01. okay, this one. After that, now valency of calcium 2 plus ion. Now calcium 2 plus ion, it is denoted by this z2, how much the higher valency, 2 plus. Okay, then 2, understood? This one. After that, next, now this one is Cl minus is there, HCl. Okay, here Cl, now Cl. So total molality, now total molality, why total molality, because see this NaCl, in NaCl, NaCl, the sodium chloride, in sodium chloride this Cl is there, and CaCl2, here also Cl, the total molality have to find out, total molality. Okay, then total molality of Cl minus, the total molality of Cl minus ion, so how much this first, for NaCl, how much for NaCl, this one is NaCl, 0.1, so 0.1 plus for CaCl2, this molality how much, 0.01, so 0.01 into, here how many, 2, na, that's why 2 multiplied by 2, then you can write 0.1 plus 0.02, then how much, 0.12. okay, this one. So total molality of Cl minus ion is 0.12, this one. Now valency of Cl minus, the valency of Cl minus ion, ion. This is Z3, and this one is how much? This one is M3. Okay, molality M3. So Z3 how much? Z3 is minus the Cl minus how many charge? Only one. Okay. So here now according to ionic strength or ionic strength formula, this one, this is this ionic strength formula. Okay. So I can write here I equal to what? Half of first is sodium. The sodium how much? Sodium, that means suppose you can write M1 Z1 square plus M2 Z2 square plus M3 Z3 square, like this. Okay, then half of M1, this M1 how much? This M1, this M1 is, see, M1 is 0.1. Okay, 0.1 into Z1 how much? 1, charge is 1, plus. Now M2 how much? M2, see, here M2 is 0.01 into Z2 square plus M3, here M3 how much? M3 0.12 into Z, this charge square. Okay, then half of now 0.1 into 1 plus 0.01 into 4 plus 0.12 to 1. So after that you will get, now you have to, this one is half of 1, 0.1 plus 0.04 plus 0.12, then half of the how much? 4, 5, 6, okay, then 6, 1, 1, 1, 2, 0.0, then you can cut this one, then 13, 0.13, okay, this one. So like this have to find out that ionic strength. Okay, this is very easy one, this ionic strength. Okay, so this ionic strength, now this finished. Next one is what? Next one is ionic mobility. So what is ionic mobility? Okay, now ionic mobility, this one is ionic mobility, it is defined as the distance traveled by an ion. So this one is, it is defined as the ionic mobility. Okay, ionic mobility. So ionic mobility, this one. So it is defined as the distance traveled by an ion per second under a potential gradient of 1 volt per meter. Okay, this one. So here ionic mobility means the distance traveled by an ion per second under a potential gradient of 1 volt per meter. Okay, this one. Now it can be calculated by actual measuring the distance traveled by any ion in given time. This given time, that means what? This is moving boundary method. Okay, for moving boundary method. Okay, then ionic mobility of any ion can also be calculated if one knows the conductance of that ion. So this one is one formula, this ionic mobility formula. How to find out? This one is U. It is denoted by U. Ionic mobility is denoted by U. Then ionic mobility equal to ionic conductance. Ionic conductance divided by ZF. Okay, ZF. Now, here is F equal to what? F equal to, this one is Faraday. Okay, where F equal to Faraday and Z has Z equal to what? This Z equal to the valence of cation. The valence of cation. Okay, this cation. So this one. So this is ionic mobility. This ionic mobility definition and this formula. U equal to ionic conductance divided by ZF. Here F equal to Faraday. And Z equal to the valence of cation. Okay, then after that this ionic mobility is finished. Then after that this one is transport number or transference number. Now how to find a transport number? Okay, so now this definition, this transport number definition, this one is transport number or transference number. Okay, TN, the fraction of the total current carried. Definition, the fraction of the total current carried by each ion is called the transport number. Okay, the transport number is very easy. This is what? The fraction of the total current carried by each ion is called the transport number. Okay, thus if U plus is the mobility of cation, U plus is the mobility of cation. Okay, and U minus that of anion. See, this one is U plus is what? U plus is mobility of cation, this cation part, and U minus that of this anion part. Okay, anion part. So transport number of the cation, this transport number of the cation, how to find out transport number of the cation equal to, or it is denoted by T plus equal to, then top side is what? Top side is current carried by the cation divided by total current. Now how to represent this one? Total current, this anion part is there and cation part is there. This downside, right? U plus U minus, and top side is U plus cation. Current carried by the cation. Okay, this one. Then T plus equal to U plus divided by U plus plus U minus. This is formula for cation. For anion, the transport number of the anion. So you can write here transport number of the anion equal to, or you can write this one is what? T minus anion, no? This way T minus equal to U minus U plus plus U minus. This one is formula. T minus equal to, that means transport number of the anion. The transport number of the anion T minus equal to U minus divided by U plus plus U minus. Okay, this one. So then overall, therefore, suppose this one T plus plus T minus, then you can write is what? You can write this one is U plus plus U minus plus u minus divided by u plus plus u minus. Now this deserves LCM. You can write u plus plus u minus, and this one u plus plus u minus. Then this one cut, no one you will get. Then ultimately t plus plus t minus equal to t minus equal to 1. So this one. So you can write this one is transport number. Then this one is what? Transport number of the cation plus transport number of the anion equal to 1. Okay, this one. And next point is one important point. This one, with increase in concentration, transport number decreasing. See, if concentration is increasing, this concentration is increasing, then transport number decreasing. Okay, this one. Further, for 1:1, okay, 1:1 electrolyte, if transport number of an ion is greater than 0, okay, 0.5, this greater than 0, this transport number, if transport number of an ion is greater than 0.5, it decreases with increase in temperature. Okay, it decreases with increase of temperature, but if it is less than, but if it is less than 0.5, this value, okay, less than 0.5, it increases with increase in temperature. It increases with increase in temperature till it approaches a value of 0.5. This is point number 1. Okay, this point number very easy one. What this one is what? If concentration increases, then transport number decreases. Same. Suppose this one is, now transport number is given, transport number is greater than 0.5. That means this is what? If transport number of an ion is greater than 0.5, it decreases with increase of temperature. But if it is less than 0.5, it increases with increase in temperature, it till approaches a value of 0.5. Okay, this one. Next, if transport number can be 0, see transport number, so transport number, point number 2, point number 1, transport number can be 0, that is, or example, at higher concentration of cadmium solution, okay, this one cadmium solution is there, this one is higher concentration, then Cd2 plus may have 0 or negative transport due to for formation of complex ion Cd4 2 minus. That means this point number is what? Point number is what? Transport number can be 0. Example, at higher concentration of Cd2 solution, the Cd2 plus may have 0 or negative transport number due to formation of complex ion Cd4 2 minus. This one point number. Okay. Now point number 3, this is another important point number, this one is what? Current carried by an ion, so current carried by an ion proportional to speed of ionic mobility of that ion proportional to U. So this one is what? Current carried by anion proportional to speed of ionic mobility of that ion proportional to U. So at infinite dilution, suppose this infinite dilution, at infinite dilution, then is what? At infinite dilution, at infinite dilution T plus infinity equal to U plus infinity plus U minus infinity, and T minus infinity equal to U minus infinity divided by U plus infinity plus U minus infinity. Okay, this one. So at infinite dilution, you can get this one and this one also. Okay. So next, this one is next is also T plus infinity into lambda infinity electrolyte, any electrolyte, say NaCl, okay, this one equal to lambda plus infinity. The another one, T transport number is negative transport number, infinity, T minus infinity into lambda infinity electrolyte equal to lambda minus infinity. Okay, this one is point number 3. Next point number is 4 number point, important one. This one is it is possible to show that this one is what? Mobility of cation divided by mobility of anion equal to, you can write here, fall of concentration round anode divided by fall of concentration round cathode. Okay, this one. So this one is last point. This is what it is possible to show that. This first one is what? This one is, this top side is, you can write mobility of cation divided by mobility of anion equal to fall of concentration round anode divided by fall of concentration round cathode part and anode part. Okay, this one. So this one is this part, this is transport number. This transport number also important, so you can practice this formula also. This is a very, very important transport number, this formula. Okay, next, then next and last point, this one is over voltage. Okay, this over voltage, this one is over voltage or bubble over voltage. Now definition, see, this one is the difference between the potential, that you can write the difference between the potential, difference between the potential of the electrode when gas evolution is actually observed, and theoretical, that is reversible value for the same is called the over voltage. That means this is over voltage, very easy one. What? The difference between the potential of the electrode. Now you can write this one as electrode, or you can choose one electrode is zinc electrode, another one is copper electrode. Okay, the copper zinc electrode, suppose this one is zinc electrode and copper electrode. So this one is what? The difference between the potential of the electrode when gas evolution is actually observed and theoretical value for the same is called overvoltage. But theoretical value same, and this one is what? This one actually, this one is observed. Okay, this is gas evolution is actually observed and theoretical value for the same is called over voltage. Suppose one example. Okay, see, this one is a chloride liberates. Okay, a chloride liberates Cl2 at the anode, but oxygen gas is also produced. But oxygen gas is also produced if the solution is diluted. Suppose one solution is diluted. Okay, see, this one is a chloride liberates Cl2 at the anode. And okay, this chloride liberates at Cl2 at the anode, but oxygen gas also produced if the solution is diluted. This is due to the over voltage. Okay, now so you can write here, this one is point number, this point one point number, this is a chloride liberates Cl2 at the anode, but oxygen gas is also produced if the solution is diluted. Okay, so this is due to over voltage. So actually this one is what? This is due to over voltage. Okay, this one. So this one is, this is over voltage, about over voltage. Okay, I hope this one is understand. Okay, if any question, please you have to comment. Okay, so please subscribe my channels for the upcoming videos, and thank you.